What do you do instead of advice giving? So we're imagining a situation where you're feeling compelled to give advice. What do you do instead? So this probably is a situation where someone's sharing a problem with you that you have a solution to and you want to share that with them. And I have another video sort of going through the reasons why it can be not helpful to give advice. But you need something to do in its place. Those are awkward moments. Someone shared something, you feel the tension, and you want that tension to be resolved. What do you do instead? So these are just 5 things to replace the advice giving. And the first one is to become a detective. And you're a detective trying to uncover the full breadth of this person's journey to solve this problem. To do this, you have to get curious. You have to ask a lot about how they've thought through the problem. And if they have the problem, you know there's probably something holding them back from doing what they should do. And that could be that they haven't fully thought through all the options. It could be that there's some psychological barrier. And you don't know what that thing is that's most holding them back. And your job as the detective is to uncover that through active listening. So you need a lot of good active listening tools if you're going to be a detective. And that's the second thing to do instead of advice giving, which is use active listening tools. This is echo questions where you're echoing back the most important word or phrase from what they just said. It's tentative lead-in phrases where you're making conjectures about what you think they mean, about what you think their perspective is, and trying to figure out how they're thinking about the problem. And I talk more about the specific active listening tools in another video. Now, the third thing when you feel compelled to give advice is assume that they've thought about it more than you have, because they probably have. Assume that they've thought about it from their own perspective, their own values, and their intelligence. And if they've just shared it with you, you probably don't know the full depth of their thinking on the matter, and so uncovering that depth is really your job. The fourth thing to do when you feel like giving advice is validate them as the heroes of their own story. It can be really encouraging and empowering if your friends and family and significant others truly believe in your ability to solve your own problems. That people feel really respected and valued when you affirm them as the heroes of their story, where you don't feel like you have to come in and be the hero for them. And this can be encouragement that you believe that they can solve the problem. And this can be as simple as just taking an interest in their story with them as the hero, asking questions that kind of imply you believe that they can solve their own problems. All of that stuff is really helpful and empowering to the other person. Show that you're interested in their journey, that their thought processes and everything that reveals about them and how they think and their values and their experiences, show that you're interested in all of that stuff that's wrapped up in this problem. This problem, if you really get to know how they think about this problem, why this is a problem for them, you're gonna get to know them as a person much more deeply. And affirming that you want to get to know them in that way through the story of this problem, that is also really helpful. And finally, the last one I'm going to say is empathizing with their feelings. And honestly, I don't think this one is always necessary. A lot of times people will start with this. They'll say, instead of giving advice, empathize with people's feelings. I think that's less important than taking an interest in how they're approaching the problem, but it can definitely be helpful when people are struggling with something to at least say things like, yeah, that seems really hard, or yeah, that's a stressful thing you're going through. That can be validating as well, and it's sort of intuiting what a person needs in a particular situation. Some people really need their feelings validated, and other people, it's more about their journey. So that's just 6 things you can do instead of giving advice if someone's sharing a problem with you.